you know, it was overrun by things I didn't like, and it was too much trouble to control it. Twitter, of course, quite famously, has had a lot of technical difficulties in the early days. And the site, even yesterday, I went to try to post something that said, sorry, too many people are on Twitter, I can't help you right now. And they have their famous fail whale graphic. And so they need to solve that very, very much. Facebook, on the other hand, I am very optimistic for Facebook. I mean, I think that they are going to continue growing very quickly. I think they're going to pass Yahoo within the next year or two to become, you know, in the very top rank of websites in terms of popularity. And I think there's something very interesting about Facebook that is going to cause a lot of noise. We're going to hear a lot about it in the future. And that is, unlike Google, so everybody talks about Google as being a potential monopoly, but with a search engine, if half the room is using one search engine and half the room is using the other search engine, it doesn't really affect anything. It doesn't bother me. If my friends use a different search engine from me, they can. I've been using Bing from Microsoft lately, which in English is quite good. I'm mostly using it just because I wanted to try something new. I understand Bing is not good in other languages, but I don't really know. But in English, it's quite good. And so I'm using Bing. No one I know has even noticed that I'm using Bing because it doesn't affect anybody else. And the fact that other people are using Google doesn't affect me, so it's easy to switch. Therefore, Google doesn't have the kind of lock-in that we see in a lot of technology. So I think it's impossible, at least on the search part of it, for Google to become a monopoly. With Facebook, it's very different. With Facebook, I'm on Facebook. All my friends are on Facebook. If I hear about a new social network, and it sounds like they've got better software, and I want to switch to it, it's very hard. What do? I convince my... I have too many friends on Facebook. I won't embarrass myself by saying how many, but my few dozen friends to move. I have to convince everyone to move, otherwise it's not possible to move. So there is a network effect that causes lock-in at Facebook, and I think Facebook is a brilliant company in terms of constantly innovating. They're still willing to take risks. I think it's probably about every 6 months when they make everybody mad by changing something on Facebook, and then they have to take it back because no one liked it. But they're willing to innovate still. They're doing very creative things. They're changing Facebook a lot. They're really tracking user behavior. And they're growing and growing and growing and growing. I don't think Facebook is going anywhere. I think the earlier companies who were in social networking never quite figured it out and failed. I mean, they must be, you know, killing themselves today because they could have, you know, Friendster could have been Facebook, but Friendster had huge downtime problems. There were times when it took 30 seconds to load a page and they lost their customers because of it. Whereas Facebook has been very aggressively making sure the site's always running, it's always fast. Well, I guess everybody's seen Facebook be broken sometimes, but it's mostly okay. So I think Facebook is really going to become one of the dominant internet companies, and they're going to be something like a monopoly, and it's going to cause a lot of very interesting discussions about what that means.
Bene, mi pare che possiamo, c'è ancora tempo per una brevissima domanda.
Sì, Sandro, ascolti, volevo chiedere, qual è la vostra relazione, diciamo, anzi, voi interagite con delle università dal punto di vista accademico, voi avete delle...
I'm sorry. No. It's funny, I have to do this. Maybe this one. Hello?
Salve. Allora, volevo chiedere, dal punto di vista delle vostre relazioni con il mondo accademico, voi avete delle collaborazioni con delle università, soprattutto poi per quel che riguarda il contenuto tecnico, cioè un contenuto che poche persone magari hanno, possono realmente, a cui poche persone possono realmente contribuire. Voi riuscite in qualche modo a sopperire a questa mancanza? Questa è la prima domanda. La seconda domanda è, in diverse lingue, una cosa che mi è successa di vedere con Wikipedia è che è vero, diciamo, che ci sono degli argomenti che vengono trattati in modo esaustivo e in modo imparziale. Peccato che però il concetto di imparzialità da un paese all'altro può variare. Una cosa che può essere imparziale in Italia non lo sarà in Russia. Se fosse riportata nello stesso identico modo, la comunità russa non lo accetterebbe. Questo porta ad avere magari di uno stesso argomento due pagine con un senso radicalmente diverso, è una cosa che ho verificato io. Voi come, diciamo, intendete risolvere questa cosa e diciamo la vedete come un problema? Grazie.
Okay. Yeah, so the first question was about cooperation with universities. We traditionally, we've not been very good at formal cooperations, because formal cooperations normally mean there would be some money involved in some way, and we have no money. So we just say, will you come and help us? And maybe they say yes, or maybe they say no. The kinds of formal cooperations that we are doing today have not been around those kinds of things that you were mentioning about getting people to edit in a certain area. Although I'll talk a little bit about the Wikipedia Academy idea, which is something like that. The kind of cooperations that we are more and more successful, particularly in Europe, because we have the local chapters who are working on this kind of thing often, is we are getting archives and libraries and museums which have access to archival content that would be useful for Wikipedia to donate it under a free license so that other people can use it. So I think one of the largest projects like this is the Bundesarchive in Germany, which is the government archive. They have a huge, massive archive of historical photographs, which they have the copyrights to. And they're making that available under free license because they realize that their mission is to preserve this history archive and to share it with the public. And what better way to share it with the public than to give it away under a free license so that anyone can use it and these things get incorporated in Wikipedia. We've also had some interesting and positive experiences with museums who are now contributing images to Wikipedia of paintings and photographs, or images of artwork in the museum. Museums used